I'm Bart Jacobs. I'm a neurologist and immunologist working in Erasmus MC Rotterdam. And I'm very interested in the Guillain-Barré syndrome and in CIDP. I'm coordinating the IGOS, or International GBS Outcome Study. That is a study that started in 2012 and that it's collecting in a very standardized way clinical data and biosamples for research. We are doing this in a very international way. So at present, 141 centers are from 20 countries are participating in the studies, and more than 1,500 patients are participating in the studies as well. And this, as far, is by far the largest study conducted in GBS. To really have important discoveries in the Guillain-Barré syndrome, it's important to have data and samples from a lot of patients that have been collected in a very standardized way. GBS is a very diverse disorder with variants, specific types of preceding infections, specific antibodies. And if you really want to investigate it in a proper way, you need to subgroup these patients and investigate them properly. So if all the patients were the same, you maybe only needed 10 patients, but if a disease is so diverse, you really need a large number. And if you need this large number, you need to have international collaboration and standardization of collection of materials. A lot of questions can be addressed by using this data biobank from IGOS. I just give you some examples. For instance, we will get a better information on the epidemiology of GBS. So is the incidence of GBS increasing with age? Is there a difference between sexes? Is there a difference in seasons when these diseases develop? Another example is that we can investigate the cause of the Guillain-Barré syndrome, so the preceding infections, the immune response to that infection and to the nerve that gives the damage, inflammatory products that come off these inflamed nerves that can be used as biomarkers to monitor patients during their disease course. It's also important, just as another example, to further improve the diagnostic criteria and the criteria for subgroups of GBS. Again, you need a large number of patients to standardize that in a proper way. So I also hope to, let's say, get a better grip on the diagnosis. And as a last example, I want to have a better idea on how to predict in an individual patient what will be the clinical course. And that's important to personalize the treatment of a patient, because if you know that the patient will recover spontaneously in a very good way, then there's very little treatment needed. But if you have a very severe case or with a very severe residual features, then you should treat more aggressively in the beginning, and we need models for that. So in the last 5 years, we largely focused on the, let's say, organization of the study and getting all the data and samples as good as we could. We are now checking those data and we are sorting out these samples, and we have already looked into the results, and what you can see is that this cohort is very representative for the worldwide GBS population. So that makes it very good for doing further research projects. Just as an example, what we could see is that if you compare patients from, let's say, Europe, from Asia, you can see that these patients are very different in some aspects. And that is very important information for further research projects. And that has never been a study that really could compare patients from these different regions. So we are studying the disease mechanisms, and that's really basic. So we're doing proteomics, mass spectrometry. These are very biochemical procedures. But on the same time, we are also investigating the long-term outcome of patients, including quality of life, if they will develop a depression. So that are very near to the patient's experiences. So it's hard science and soft science at the same time. I think it's fair to say that it's unlikely that this study could have been done without support of the GBS-CIDP Foundation. So what was very important, that when the idea came up, that the foundation was willing to give us funding, so we could make the first start. We could develop a website for entering those data. We could approach other people. We could organize meetings. And without that support, it would have been very difficult to start with the study. But along the track of this study, the foundation had been instrumental with supporting for biobank facilities and has now again supported us by helping us with a data manager, because there are so many data that you need a computer expert to sort out all the different research questions. I'm very grateful to the foundation for their support of the project. I think GBS and CIDP are complex diseases for doctors in general. So if you don't have a lot of experience with diagnosing or treating GBS or CIDP, you could end up in problems. It's important that these neurologists that are confronted with the patient, that they have, they can contact a real expert in this field. But also it's important for patients to know that if they want to have this expertise on board for their disease, that they know how to find the right neurologist. So I think the Centers of Excellence is a very good way, supported by the foundation, to identify these centers. I think it's working already very well in the Netherlands. There are in the Netherlands two centers that have these excellent status, that is in Rotterdam and in Amsterdam. And what I also already see is that we are very frequently consulted by patients or by neurologists about problems with GBS or CIDP.